Today I'm working with Ken Oliver's Color Burst Powders and the brand new Liquid Metals. As you'll see, the Liquid Metals work beautifully with the Color Burst Powders, adding a really nice metallic luster. You'll also see me try different things with the Liquid Metals, techniques you might not initially think suitable, but that work really well. Watch and you'll see how Liquid Metals even work with the gel press plate. There are a lot of folks demoing how to use the Liquid Metals with the Color Burst Powders, and I will do that, but a little bit later on. What I wanted to show you first is something that's a little bit more unusual, which is to use the Liquid Metals on a gel press plate as part of the process of monoprinting. You can see that I've got some samples here, and one of the things that you'll notice as I turn this and I let the light catch it is a very subtle metallic sheen that's in there. I think it's a little bit more noticeable here. In fact, it's a lot more noticeable here. And then you can, of course, see it here too. So the way to achieve this, first of all, black paper is important because, as you'll see, I've done the same thing on white paper, and while the sheen is there, it just is more visible against the black. So for my purposes here, I'm going to work with the black. Now, one of the things that you might wonder is, how strong is the color in the Liquid Metals, and does it really blend with the color on the, whatever color you're using on the plate? And the answer is yes. This was the acrylic basic, the Liquitec Basics Brilliant Yellow Green. I believe that was this. And then it was the amethyst, metallic amethyst on the Liquid Metals. And you can see, ordinarily when you mix colors opposite on the color wheel, you end up with brown or something muddy and not particularly attractive. What you have here is something that's not really green and not really purple. Unfortunately, it didn't turn brown. So the word to the wise is that you do need to think about that a little bit. What's in this bottle will definitely work with or against the color that you put on the plate. You'll also notice that I've got some junk left over here on the plate, and that's deliberate. I find that it's way more interesting to leave the previous stuff here and to use it as part of the next print. Now, obviously, if you're printing something very specific, then you probably want to start with a clean plate, but you don't always have to. So I think what I'm going to do is let's bring in some of the blue violet. I'm going to put a little bit out here. Now you have to remember that the Liquid Metals are going to add to the volume of paint on the plate, so you don't want to overdo it because then you'll end up with just way too much paint and you don't get as nice a print. So that is light blue violet in the Liquitec Basics line. I think I'm going to pick up, this is the metallic amethyst, so I think I'll pick up a little bit of this. I'm just going to put some out on the plate. So I've kind of got purple and purple. I don't have to worry about any color change going on. And you'll see that this doesn't brayer in the normal fashion. You can kind of see it on the brayer. You just have to give yourself a moment here to work the colors in together. Now you can blend more and more if you want, or you can sort of stop wherever you think you've hit a point that you like. So I'm just going to brayer the paint off. I've got some deli paper off to the side here. I'm going to bring in, I want to say this is one of our heart stencils, Heart Delight, Heart something or other. This is one that I designed about a year ago. So I'm going to lay this on here, and I'm going to bring in a piece of, this is just paper towel. The reason that I like this, if you've watched the gel press videos that I've done previously, you'll notice that there's a design embossed on here. And what happens is when you press through the openings in the stencil, you will remove some of the paint, but as long as you don't overdo it, you'll actually leave some of the pattern of the paper towel behind, and you can see that here. So I'm just going to do this part right here. And anything else that I think got missed, but that actually looks pretty good. So I'm going to let it alone. I'm going to lift the stencil. I'm going to grab, this is again from the Strathmore 6x6 artist tile. This happens to be the black. So I'm going to lay this on here. Now let's lay it here. I've got a piece of scratch paper that I've been using so that I keep my hands out of the paint that's on the rest of the plate. Just want to make sure I give this a good push so I know I'm getting good contact. Get rid of that. And off this comes. And how cool is that? You get what's left from the previous print. You get the pattern of those hearts as they form that circular flower, and you get the design from the embossing on the paper towel. So you wouldn't think that working with Liquid Metals on a gel press plate would be something you might initially reach for and try, but it really does produce great results. Okay, so let's try the more traditional application of liquid metals with the color burst powders, although of course this will have a Barbie spin on it, primarily because I simply can't be normal. I have to find my own weird way of making things my own. So I have three colors. I have chartreuse, lime green, and turquoise, and then I have platinum in the liquid metals. It's the one that seems to transform itself the most based on what color you put it with. It will kind of pick up the color burst color and morph and change, so I really like platinum for its ability to kind of be many different things. When I do this, I can't put the water down and then sprinkle the powder down. Well, I can, but I'm not happy with the results. So what I like to do is apply a tiny little bit of powder, because again, I prefer lighter colors to really deep ones, but I'm going to show you a way that you can change that if it gets too deep. So I'm going to start with powder on dry paper, and then I'm going to add water. Now, this is, again, this is one of the Strathmore. This is cold-pressed watercolor paper that comes from this artist tile pad. They're the ultimate in convenience. They're all cut. They're all ready to go. The paper is 140 pound. It's super high quality. I reach for this all of the time. So I'm going to, this is just my thing. I typically start with the lighter colors, although for this application, because I'm putting them all on at the same time, it really doesn't make a darn bit of difference, but it's just kind of habit. Now the granules are tiny and they're fairly light colored, so you may not see much of anything, but trust me, there is some color going on. Some of these pop out of the bottle a little bit faster than others. I am not squeezing the bottle at all. I'm simply tipping or angling in some cases if it comes out really quickly, like that was the lime green that just did. All I want to do is just get the littlest bit of powder out as possible. But like I said, if it gets too dark, I will show you how you can fix that. So at first blush, that might not seem like very much, but the minute the water hits it, you're going to see, in fact, how much it really is. So I'm just going to start spritzing, and you'll see the colors begin to bloom. Now the paper will lift a little bit. You wet any paper enough, and it's certainly going to do that. Now, I don't like to add too much water because I want to maintain some of the patterning that kind of happens automatically. The other thing that I like to do is to grab a brush to get my big fat finger out of there so I'm not leaving a giant finger mark. That kind of stops the water from pushing the color toward the edges as the paper lifts. And you'll also see that I'm going to use a brush to do something pretty different. So in comes the platinum liquid metals. Now because this is metal suspended in a solution, you have to shake it really well in order to get everything up and moving. So I've done that, and now what I'm going to do is start dropping some of the platinum on here. Now it kind of looks white. If you think about it, platinum is more or less a white metal. So this is kind of pretty. It's interesting. It bursts and it spreads and wicks out depending on how much liquid is on the surface. And you can certainly cause it to wick out a little bit more by putting some more water in there. Or you can, this is why my fingers look the way they do, you can stick your finger in here and start moving the color around. Now I don't know where that black is coming from. I'm not going to sweat it. It is what it is. And I'm just going to do this and move the color around. So I like this. I'm probably not going to do much more than dry it, but you'll notice that if I pick this up, it does want to start to lift. So I could bring in my heat tool and I could start to dry this, which I'm going to do, but there's not enough of the there's not enough of the platinum on here to do what I really want to do. So what I'm going to do is get another one to almost this point, because I don't want to flood this with platinum. It's going to be too much and it won't look really good. Like anything, too much of even a good thing is still too much. So let me dry this, let me clean up, and then I'm going to come back with one that's just about at this stage, only a little bit drier, but you're going to see there's a mess on the table. I'm going to show you how you can use Tim's Distress Wrinkle-Free technique and pick up some of what's left on your table. So let me get that done, and I will be right back. So you can see residue left on the table from the card that you saw me do, the artist tile that you saw me do a moment ago, and then here's some more from this one that I've just done. Now this is partly dry, so what I'm going to do now, this is slightly different than the first time, but I'm going to shake the platinum and I'm going to bring it in, and I'm going to drop it in a few places, and then I'm going to add some more water so that we can get it moving. There's lots of different ways to do this. There's no right way, there's no set way. It just is whatever either works for you or what you happen to be doing on a given day. So I'm going to come back and just kind of hold this in the center. I'm going to spritz a little bit just to give the liquid metals something to move in. This time, instead of moving this with my finger, I'm going to move it with the end of a brush. And you can see that I can create patterns with this end of the brush by just pulling the metallic color out. I can create these kind of starburst effects if I want, which is kind of interesting. Now, obviously, the more water you have on here, the more wicking and spreading all of the colors will do, even the ones that are already on there from when you first worked on it. But this does give you the opportunity to kind of do some fun experimental things. And obviously, you can pull this color out. It doesn't have to just be with the liquid metals, but you can certainly do it this way. All right, so let me set this to one side. Let me get it out of the way. And I want to bring that other one back in for a moment. I just have to figure out where I put it. All right, so here it is. And you can see that there's still some water left on here. So I'm going to shake it off like this, kind of get most of it off. Now here's an opportunity when something goes wrong that you can fix it. Not that there's anything on here that's particularly dark, but let's just say for one second that I didn't like this area. I thought it was too dark. If you take a dry paper towel and you blot it, you'll remove color. So that's a way to lighten something. And you, of course, can do this because these are watercolors. They're meant to be re-wetted if you choose to do that. So if you find something that's too dark, even something you did a week ago, hit it with some water and pick it up with a paper towel, or blot it with a dampened paper towel, and you can make it work that way. So let me just, because for this technique to work, this needs to mostly be dry, let me just take this over to the side for 1 second and see if I can kind of hasten the drying in these areas where there's a fair amount of water. There's nothing worse than watching paint dry. So I'm just going to do it for a second so I can kind of sop up and remove some of that extra. And in fact, I'm going to do it with a paper towel. All right. So now what I've got is this puddle left in the center. And if you're familiar with Tim Holtz's distress wrinkle-free technique, it involves turning the front of your piece over and laying it in the kind of mess that remains, and you get really interesting dotted patterns. Now, the bigger the blotch of water on here, the bigger the blob of color you're going to get on this card. But you have little dots of water, you have big dots, you can do lots of different things. And you see you get this secondary pattern that starts to form. And if I take this over to the side, which I will kind of do, although really it's going to take far too long, but if I take this over to the side and dry it, I can come back and do this again. Now, if I want to make things even more interesting, I can bring back some of the platinum, and I can just put a couple of drops on here, maybe hit it with a little bit of water to spread it out, and I'm just talking a little bit of water here. And in fact, if I want to get totally crazy, and I think that there's not enough color at all, or if I want to bring in another one, like this is chartreuse, which I did not use on the second one, but I can just come in and sprinkle a little chartreuse in here. Of course, it's the powder is so light, I can't even see if any's come out. But I'm going to hit this with some water, and if there's chartreuse there, it'll bloom. It doesn't look like there's a lot, so I'm going to come back. There it goes. And sprinkle some more out there. This gives you an opportunity to do some really interesting and different things. So I'm going to lay this in there again and pat. And you can do this for as many layers as you would like. And you see how fabulous this gets. You get these multi-layers, all of these elements overlapping. You get the metallic that's in there. And so you get this beautiful background that's ready for you to do just about anything with. A couple of quick techniques just to finish up. This first one uses the liquid metals on, this is one of my 4x4 art cards. So it's a piece of Strathmore's 4x4 Bristol paper that comes from the Artist Tile Pack. I put a coat of gesso on there, and then I applied some kind of acrylic paint. At a guess, it's either Dina Wakely End or the Liquitex Basics. Very lightly with my fingers, that's how I get this patterning on here. Now, there's no reason you can't come along and add a sheen of liquid metals if you want. So all I'm going to do, this is saffron, I'm going to put a couple of drops on here. Now remembering that the color on my fingers will reactivate, about the only clean finger I have left is my pinky, so that's what I'm going to use. You could do this with a brush too if you want. If I want to add a little bit of water to thin this out, I can. But all I'm doing is just adding a thin layer of the saffron, so I'm getting a little bit of yellow, and of course I'm getting all of the yellow glimmer as well. Now, what you're seeing coming off here is probably coming off of my fingers because everything that's on here is a permanent when dry kind of product. So that's a little bit of the saffron itself and probably some of the mess that's on my fingers. Once this dries, I'll have this great sheen of glimmer on there, which you're probably not going to be able to see because it's wet, but trust me, it's there. And it just adds another layer of complexity and interest to this particular artist tile or art card, which is what I think of them as. So don't think that you have to use them just with the gel press plate or only with the color burst powders themselves. So let's come back to this for 1 second. Now that this is dry, this is one of the ones that I was working on in the last segment or the last couple of segments. What I want to show you is because these re-wet, you can do lots of other things with them. So I just have water in a bottle, and I'm kind of holding it up high. I just want to spritz some kind of big fat old droplets on there. Let it sit for a moment. Now, one thing that I have noticed is that the metallics, the liquid metals, don't lift quite as readily, but watch what happens. I'm going to lift this up, and there's the spots pattern. So how cool is that? If you wanted to spritz through a stencil and you use Diane Reevely's ghosting technique, I'm positive that would work as well. I haven't done it, but if this works, there absolutely is no reason why that won't. So Ken Oliver's liquid metals are a fabulous little product. That's not a liquid metal. Available in lots of different color, and quite honestly, my favorite is platinum. It may not be yours, but I think you should try them. They're well worth the investment.